Hi, I'm Dean Perrine, Executive Vice President of JSA, and on behalf of 365 Data Center, I would like to welcome the man of the hour himself, the CEO of 365 Data Centers, Mr. Bob DeSantis. Bob, it is always a pleasure speaking with you. Thanks for taking the time to chat with me today.
Thanks, Dean. Glad to be here. I wish we were down at our favorite setting in Miami this time of year, but we'll do with this.
You and me both, Bob. Here in Chicago, it's not quite Miami. But anyway, so Bob, let's just go ahead and jump in with the most obvious question. 2020 was an uncertain year, to say the least, for a lot of folks in the industry. And while there are a number of those uncertainties, as the industry pivoted, 365 seemingly, you know, weathered those pivots, weathered the uncertainty of 2020 pretty well, and really came out in great shape. You had a lot of stuff going on. Your business strategy was affirmed in a lot of different ways in 2020. But why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about the year that was 2020 for 365 Data Centers?
Sure, Dean. Happy to do that. It clearly was a year of challenges and opportunities. And I must say, you refer to it as probably the most transactional year, you know, for 365 since my partners and I acquired the platform business back in 2017. So maybe a rapid run through the year. At the end of January last year, we acquired a premier data center asset in Commack, Long Island, a 25,000 square foot, 6 megawatt facility. I must say it's probably the jewel of our portfolio today, you know, very high density opportunity. And, we acquired that asset from Ricoh, the large international company out of Japan. Their subsidiary Mindshift became a very long-term, substantial customer of 365 as part of that transaction. So it was kind of a double win for us. In February, late February, I think we did a very nice job in retrospect, really nothing to compare it to because none of us have been through a pandemic before, at least in our lifetime. And I think we got ahead of it in late February. We put together a task force, very focused on the fact that we are a central services business, set out four main objectives for the company. One was to keep our employees and our customers safe, which I think, you know, is just prevalent among any business. Secondly, to keep our supply chains, totally open, which we didn't know what impact it would be because, you know, we do order equipment, we order circuits, we do a lot of different things. Thirdly, to communicate with our customers, you know, let them know we were ahead of this thing and, you know, they could come into our data centers if they needed to, but we put measures in place that enabled us to do a lot of remote hands for them on, you know, on a no charge basis to try to keep them safe and others. And then, of course, to protect our financial resources. And, you know, almost a year later now, you know, I can say the team has done a very nice job, a good combination, I think, of good planning and having, you know, what I think is, you know, the best in class group of employees in this industry who were very loyal, showed up at the data centers every day, kept them open, kept them running, and knock on wood, we really haven't had any major issues. And I, you know, so that certainly has prevailed all throughout the year, not just in February and March, but I think we did get ahead of it and I don't think we've lost a beat. So really proud of the team for that. Throughout the pandemic, we did quite a few things, I think, to fortify the business. Two of the things that we did strategically slash operationally was we added a large upgrade to our power capacity in Tampa. And of course, we're always doing upgrades, but that one was important, along with a very strategic partnership up in Buffalo, New York, to further enhance our position as the gateway into Canada through some subsea partner arrangements that terminate at our data center. And so, you know, we are well known, I think, throughout the industry now of being very network-centric, very important regional hub operator for Chicago East, but our Tampa and Buffalo facilities, really drive that measure for us. And, those two types of activities, I think, you know, put us far ahead as the leader in those two markets as the network-centric hub. In late September, early October, we announced a major recapitalization of the business. So I'd say on top of our day jobs, we were busy on the, I guess on the strategic front, beyond just running an essential business during a pandemic, we recapitalized the business. We welcomed Stonecourt Capital, which is a BlackRock backed firm that came in, investment firm that came in and took a majority equity stake in 365. And that really positions us extremely well for further growth financially. And, you know, brings additional expertise to what I think was a very, very strong, you know, ownership group and board. And so we're very, very pleased that Stonecourt has joined us. And, you know, our future growth, whether it continues to be organic combined with external, I think we're well positioned for. And then if that wasn't enough, in November, we closed a transaction by acquiring Atlantic Metro Communications. Which is a business that, or was a business, now it's part of 365, that provided tailored, very tailored colocation network and cloud services for its customers, which are now our customers. And, you know, that was a very strategic transaction and very much in alignment with our M&A disciplines and strategies. So that's kind of a couple of minutes on the year behind us.
So that's all, huh?
Yeah, that's all. I think we spoke last year. I mentioned I saw the year being busy, but like I said, it was probably, you know, that's the fourth acquisition we've closed since April of 2017. And, but, you know, clearly the year was a very busy year. Like I said, full of challenges, full of opportunities, and, you know, really proud of the team that they executed on those opportunities while dealing with significant challenges.
Outstanding, Bob. You know, and congratulations again. I wish we were in Miami right now. I could shake your hand. But I've been reading, keeping up with 365. You know, for the last 18 months, and you know, congratulations is truly in order. But let's go ahead and talk a little bit about Atlantic Metro a bit more, because that's a significant acquisition. Why don't you tell us a little bit more about why Atlantic Metro, why it was such a good sound strategic decision for 365.
Yeah, I'd be happy to do that. You know, there were several reasons. And I think as we've talked before, you know, having an M&A discipline is important, particularly when it's focused around products and markets. So I guess first and foremost, it, you know, it just continues our strategy of being positioned in what I like to call the Northeast quadrant of the United States. I'm not talking about the Northeast. I'm talking about that quarter of the country that's in the Northeast, plus Tennessee, plus Florida, because we really, really like the business climates in Tennessee and Florida. And so what Atlantic Metro brought us was, you know, not only customers, but facilities and network that reach Boston, New York, New Jersey, Philadelphia, Northern Virginia, and then, you know, down in Miami in Florida. So that fit very, very well. It also immediately added more credence to our, you know, our network colocation brand, just because of all the network connectivity and the additional data center that it brings. You know, I think it makes 365 a much more viable cloud operator. Cloud still is third in our portfolio of businesses between, you know, our services behind colocation and network. But it really, I think, gives us a much more viable, you know, entry into the market on our cloud and virtual products. And you know, with the broader set of infrastructure as a service offerings, it just makes us more competitive in every market. You know, beyond that, it doubled our customer base. You know, we're now 1,300 customers strong, and that's significant for us.
I was waiting for that.
Yeah. And, you know, that customer base was very similar in many ways. You know, the top 10 customers complemented very nicely. You know, the medium-sized customers and the small-sized customers, you know, were very complementary, you know, with regard to our existing base. So it had an overall very, very positive impact on our customer profile, and that just allows for more cross-selling and upselling. So that was key. And then it immediately almost doubled, close to doubled our revenue base, and significantly enhanced our EBITDA to the next level, really. And we were very pleased where we had grown that. And that just gives us much more financial flexibility that those of us who came up through the financial world understand is what you need for a very viable business. And then I think finally, I think when we first were looking at the business, I thought it would maybe put us among the few, but now I think it really makes us the leading, you know, fully hybrid infrastructure as a service business from Chicago East. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think those were the strategic reasons for doing it. And, you know, we got a heavy lift in front of us. We got a good integration effort. You know, we're hoping to get that fully baked in by summer. And I think we will. Good team doing it. And, you know, so that was the rationale, Dean, behind that acquisition.
Thank you very much for that, Bob. But enough about the past. Let's go ahead and talk about the future. There were a lot of lessons to be learned in 2020. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the lessons that 365 Data Centers learned from kind of going through what was an uncertain year in 2020 and how you're going to apply those for 2021. And then any industry predictions you have for me, I'd love to hear them.
Industry predictions. All right. Well, let me see if I can cover last year first where we start predicting. So, I think the lessons learned from my perspective, or maybe reaffirmed is a better wording for it. I think proper preparation, you know, I think in life, anything you do, right. But certainly in the business world, just being properly prepared. I think for businesses that have, external growth aspirations as we do, just sticking to an M&A discipline. I think we talked about that a little bit last year. You know, this was an easy year to focus on opportunities if you had the time and the resources to do it. But sticking to a discipline in M&A, I think, is a big lesson to adhere to. And proper execution. You know, you got to execute when you have those opportunities. And I think, with that, good preparation, discipline, execution, you know, I think even in the most challenging times like last year, you know, you can succeed in taking advantage of opportunities, which again, I think we had a very successful year doing, and hopefully another one coming up. Being in the data center business, i.e. associated with data storage and transport, is the business to be in. You know, I think it has been for, you know, a good part of the last decade, but certainly if there's any positive coming out of a pandemic, you know, certainly it's told us that if you can store data and transport it and have network connectivity, who knows where the world's going, but it's certainly not going back to where it was. And so I think being at the right place, right time, in the right industry, is very important. And I think we're in that industry. I think there's a lot of money on the sidelines and a lot of investors who want to invest more in the industry. And I think there are many that are Johnny come lately that are dying to get into it now and to acquire assets that, that can enable data storage and transport. And I think there's been some consolidation, and I think there's fewer assets to go around today than there was 4 years ago, than there was 3 years ago. And I think my prediction is that you're going to see continued M&A. I think you're going to see continued consolidation. I think we've already seen multiples start to move up. And I think my prediction is over the next 24 months, I think we'll see multiples 2 to 3 turns higher over the next 24 months than they've been over the last 24 months. And I think that's just a function of data storage, data transport, assets just becoming more and more valuable and a lot more smart money chasing it. So that's my prediction, Dean. I hope I'm right. So.
I love it, Bob. What I don't love is that we're doing this virtually. How about 2022 at least? I go to Miami, we get a good handshake, and we can do this maybe on the beach?
I'll certainly help you out in Miami to find the beach. How's that?
That sounds great. Right. So, Bob, thanks again. It's always a pleasure speaking with you. I appreciate it.
No, thanks, Dean. Appreciate it.